In the last video, we looked into function composition. Let's see all of this in practice. Let's start by defining our functions. So our first function is increment. It's going to receive a number and it's going to return 1 unit above it. Let's try our increment with value 2, and we see 3 as an output on the right side. Let's define the type for increment. I'm using capital letters for my types. Then increment is going to receive a number and it's going to return a number. So adding this to our function, save, same result. Our next function is toString. It's going to receive a number and it's going to return a string representation of it. So like this. For the sake of this demo, I'm going to wrap my strings in double quotes just to distinguish them from numbers in the output. Let's define a type for toString. It's receiving a number and returning a string. All right. Let's try our toString with 2. And if we save, we see 2 as in a string in the output. Next, let's try composing increment and toString. Meaning that I want to define a function that receives an input, pass that to increment, pass the output of that to a string. So our compose function is going to receive a number and return the string. I started my defining my function by first defining a signature of it. This is a really well-known practice in functional programming. So it's always a good idea to start defining your functions by first defining the signature for that function. All right, let's define our increment then to string. It's going to receive a number and it's going to call increment over it. Then it's going to call to string onto increment. Let's add a type to this, increment then to string. And let's try our new function, increment then to string. This time let's try this with value 6, and if we save, we see 7 as an output. Great. But here we are actually composing our increment and toString by hard coding it. Wouldn't it be nice if we could have a function, let's say called compose, that receives increment and toString as an input and returns a compose function? So let's try this. Our compose function is going to get two functions, f and g, increment and toString. Then it's going to receive a value, a number in our case, and it's going to first call g over it and then call f over the output of g. Let's try this. Let's define our increment then to string. Let's call this one 2 just to not have a conflict. And let's use our compose function this time, increment and to string. So now we are passing to string and increment as parameters to our compose. And we are compose and we are getting the compose function. Let's try this. Console log increment then to string 2. Again, let's try this with value 6. And if we save, we are seeing 7 again. Pretty great. All right, let's add the types to these. We already have increment then to string type here. And let's define a type for our compose. So what is the type for this? Compose is going to receive two functions. The first function is receiving a number and return a string, and the second function is receiving a number and returns a number. Then the compose function is going to receive a number and returns a string. Let me clean this up a little bit. So this here, I'm going to put the G underneath it and put this here. Look much better. But there's a problem here. Our compose function is really tied to number and a string. It would be really nice if you could just say G is receiving a placeholder, any type A, and returns any type B. F receives B and returns any type C. So our compose function at the end is going to receive A and return C. Good thing that TypeScript has this feature called generics. So we can just specify these placeholders or type parameters here. And now, no errors. If we save again, same results. What's happening here? So how does this A, B, C is going to be specified? These are going to be inferred when we are actually using the compose function. We forgot something. Let's add the compose to our compose function, compose type to our compose function. And if we save, same result. And here we go. All right. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.